Hello, my name's Dave. Welcome to my YouTube channel if you haven't been here before. And if you have and have subscribed, thank you very much. And we've now passed over the 2,000 subscriber mark, so very much appreciated. Just cover a little about the previous video measuring the exhaust port timing and the method that we used. There's other methods that we would use if we were doing the port time analysis. But just to make a point is these videos are not going to be explaining all things in detail. I'm just going to be showing you the particular things that you need to do this job, which is to measure a pipe that you might have or make an expansion chamber, okay? And we're not doing anything else. That's basically what these videos are about, just to be clear. So I won't go into detail that we don't need to go into. And as for the pipe, you know, and the design, we're going to get straight into tuned length, because there's some people who might have like those motorized bicycles with the pipes they sell them and a funny long header on it, and you know, you never know whether the pipe's working or not. You can use this to calculate the tuned length of those pipes and at least measure your pipe and see if it's actually going to be in the ballpark of what it should be. It might sound okay, but it might not be making any power. And it's not difficult to do this stuff. It just, there's a few steps to go through, but you can do it all with a basic calculator on your PC, no problem at all. And the next thing we're going to get into after we've got the exhaust port timing now is called calculating the brake mean effective pressure. There's a couple of reasons we need that, but the first one for tuned length is we actually need to estimate what the temperature is, because we need to know, you know, how long the exhaust port is open for. That's the first step. And then we know the speed of the engine at peak, so we know how many milliseconds or whatever the exhaust port is open for, so that's time. Then we've got to calculate how fast sound travels in the gas, and to do that we need to know what the temperature of the gas is, so to know how far it will travel and back during the time the exhaust port's open. So that's pretty much what it is. So I'll get straight into the calculations of Bmep next, which are quick and easy, and it just basically takes calculating the swept volume. So I'll briefly show you that. Just to familiarise you with the function of Bmep, I'll just go back to the software. Now, just somebody asked me if this software is going to be downloadable. At this stage, probably not. I just wrote it because it allows me to do some demonstrations for the purpose of these two straight videos. Just makes it easy to show a few things along the way, okay? Now, brake mean effective pressure. Just have a look over here in this thing here. Now, I don't know if you can see this. This might be a problem in the resolution of the screen. And I'd like you to tell me if you can't see these figures on the screen while I'm actually doing these screenshots. Because if you can't, maybe I'll have to record it in 720p. So please let me know in the comment section if that's the case. We calculate the BMEP, the brake mean effective pressure, which is actually the average cylinder pressure. So we calculate the average cylinder pressure because we want to know what the average pressure of the cylinder is, so that we know how big to make the midsection of the, let's do a pipe here, the midsection of the pipe here, and how small we want the outlet side of the pipe. Okay, so that's two reasons that we want to know the BMEP. The other reason we want to know the BMEP is it gives us a rough guide to the actual exhaust temperature using the figures correlations given by Professor Blair. So that's why we want to calculate the BMEP, because then from that we're going to estimate what the temperature is. Now, if you know what the temperature of the expansion chamber is, then you can just use that, but you'll still want to know the BMEP anyway for the latter purposes in designing in putting in these figures. Okay, so we'll go through it. To calculate the BMEP, first of all we need to know what the swept volume is. If you look over on this center screen here, we've got volumes, swept volume, don't worry about the trap volume. This is not the particular timing of the engine, but this is one of those Zeta engines with a bore of 47 mil and a stroke of 38 mil, power of 2.2 kilowatts. And those are the figures that we use to calculate the BMEP. So we've got an RPM figure of 2.2 kilowatts at 6,000 RPM for a particular motor, which I looked up. And for that bore and stroke size, over here we have a swept volume of 65.93 cc's for that particular engine. So calculating 2.2 kilowatts power, we get a Bmep of 3.34 bar. Now, bar, if you use a calculator, converter, you can calculate that, convert it into PSI if you like, just for, you know, for your own estimations. But it's not necessary. We're going to stick to metrics because the bar scale is the one that, that Blair uses, so that's why we're going to work to that. Now, the next thing we need to calculate is the swept volume. Now, this is usually the rating of the engine, so you can get the rated value. It might even be cast on the bottom of the cylinder jug. But if you don't know the swept volume, that's how many cc's the engine is. This is how to calculate it. And this is a mistake I made in the previous video that I actually deleted. So this is a second update video. Swept volume equals pi divided by 4. And you can use your calculator, scientific calculator. Press the pi button so you can go pi divided by 4 to get that number. Times bore times the bore. Times stroke divided by 1,000. So that equation will give you the swept volume in cubic centimetres or cc's. And then once we know the swept volume, we use that down in this equation to get the BMEP or brake mean effective pressure, which is the average cylinder pressure. We begin with kilowatts and RPM and swept volume. So we've got our swept volume here in cc's. And we have our RPM and our kilowatts. So that is, if you look at the specifications of the engine, it'll have it rated at a certain amount of kilowatts of power at a certain amount of RPM. So use that RPM figure. So the equation is 10,000 times kilowatts divided by swept volume times RPM divided by 60. So just calculate your 10,000 times your kilowatts, write that down. Calculate your RPM divided by 60, write that down. Swept volume times that figure, and then get that figure. Divide this figure by that figure to get your total equation, which is your BMEP value. And that's that step. So we'll move on to the next one. So now you've got your swept volume and your RPM for the peak and your BMEP value, and from that, as I said, about 350 degrees when we're getting down to 3.5 bar, up to 600 degrees for 11 bar. So you can estimate the temperature in between that. That is temperature at peak, flat out, with the engine in, you know, top gear flat out, because that temperature, of course, in the exhaust does vary quite a bit. Okay, so now we've got our exhaust timing, the period that the exhaust port's open for. We've got our average temperature. We can now, and our RPM, we can now calculate the tune length value that we should have, okay, which this software does in here. But I will show you the equation to do that. And just keep that BMEP figure in mind, because later on, when we actually go to dimension the pipe, we'll be using that in calculating the port to mid ratio and the port to outlet ratio. And I think that will do it for now. And hopefully we'll see you in the next video. Please share this video. I was hoping how to make expansion chambers was kind of what this was all about. The videos have only got about 360 views, I think. And it's kind of odd because all the emails and questions I've been getting is, can you design a pipe for me? And this is actually the videos to design the pipe. We're getting straight to it, and one or two more videos will pretty much cover it. So share it. If anyone wants to know how to design a pipe the quick and easy way using Blair's figures, Professor Gordon Blair's figures, then let them know about the video. And if you haven't subscribed yet, please subscribe and check out the next video, which won't be as delayed as this one was. And that will do it for now. Okay, thanks for coming on the channel and watching it. And we'll see you in the next one, I hope. Bye for now.